According to a new WHO report, more women are surviving pregnancy and childbirth than ever before. In just the last 23 years, we've seen a decline of 40% in maternal deaths. However, as unprecedented aid cuts take effect around the world, UN agencies are warning of a threat of major backsliding. We all know someone who's expecting a baby, right? Our maternal health expert, Dr. Femi Oladapo, is our expert on the show today. Welcome, Dr. Femi. You've had years of experience in the field delivering babies. Talk to us about what a mother needs to know about how she can have a safe pregnancy and delivery.
Thank you, Vismita. The birth of a child is a major life event, potentially a time of hope, new beginning, and joy. But it can also be a time of fear and complications. For a woman to have a healthy pregnancy, for starters, access to routine medical checkups and good nutrition are essential to prevent complications during pregnancy.
What kind of tests are included in these antenatal checkups?
During these checkups, a woman should expect to have tests like urine tests, blood tests, ultrasound, glucose screening, blood pressure checks, as well as monitoring of her baby's growth.
And then in addition to these tests, what are the other things she should keep in mind during pregnancy?
There are some warning signs that might indicate that a complication is about to set in. Women should watch out for things like vaginal bleeding, severe headache, or swelling of the legs. And if any of this emerge, a woman should contact her healthcare provider.
Dr. Femi, let's talk about a major killer for women during childbirth, hemorrhage. Why are so many women still dying of hemorrhage in this day and age?
It's a reality that maternal death is still a major issue worldwide. In 2023, 260,000 women died as a result of complications of pregnancy or childbirth. Hemorrhage is the leading cause of maternal death, and it accounts for over 25% of maternal death that occurred in 2023. If you look at that number, that is roughly 700 maternal deaths in a day, about one in every 2 minutes. That's like a jumbo jet crashing every day. High blood pressure disorders, known as pre-eclampsia, is another major cause. But the real tragedy is that many of these deaths are preventable.
So clearly, hemorrhage is a big killer. But WHO has a solution that's turning the tide, right?
Yes, exactly. The complications and serious health outcomes that are associated with postpartum hemorrhage are preventable if it's identified early. The key to this is rapid detection and effective treatment. Unlike in the past, where doctors and nurses, guess the amount of blood that a woman is losing, WHO has come up with a powerful solution, a special plastic sheet that is called calibrated drape, whereby the blood loss of a woman is measured more accurately. So immediately after the birth of the baby, the healthcare providers would slip this beneath the buttocks of the woman. The blood loss is then collected.
Ah!
As soon as the blood loss reaches a certain point, in this case, 500 mils, a set of treatments are provided to the woman almost at the same time, within 15 minutes. From the study that was conducted, over 200,000 women were involved. This approach was shown to reduce severe blood loss of more than a liter, surgery to stop bleeding or death by as much as 60%.
So Dr. Femi, I remember when I was expecting my child, there were so many people to advise, my mother, my relatives. But nowadays, it's even more, right? There's digital media, there's misinformation, there's good information, there's too much information. What is it that a woman needs to know about her rights while going through pregnancy and delivery?
Very important question. A woman who is pregnant has the right to a safe, positive pregnancy, childbirth, and postnatal experience where they are treated with dignity and respect. They have the right to have a companion of their choice to be with them throughout the pregnancy journey, including during labor and childbirth. They have the right to move around when they're in labor, and they have the right to choose the birth position. And she has the right to have pain relief. In terms of advice, I would advise women to consult their healthcare providers much earlier in pregnancy so that they can work out a plan, what we call a birth plan, to ensure that they have a safe pregnancy and childbirth outcome. When women have control of their health and lives, we see healthy mothers and healthy babies.
Thank you, Dr. Femi. That was Science in 5 today. Until next time, men stay safe, stay healthy, and stick with science.